Hi, I'm Will Dillman from the South Carolina Department of Natural Resources. We're here today at the Aiken Gopher Tortoise Heritage Preserve, a site where we are working to establish a population of tortoises. Today we're here releasing some tortoises that have been head started over the last 2 years with our partners at Savannah River Ecology Lab and Riverbanks Zoo. I think Kurt's going to tell you a little bit more about what Savannah River Ecology Lab has done.
I'm Kurt Buhlman from the University of Georgia's Savannah River Ecology Lab, and our team, working with DNR, working with the Longleaf Alliance, Fish and Wildlife Service, and Riverbank Zoo, has been working on reestablishing a population of tortoises here at the Tortoise Preserve. I'm holding here what we call a waif tortoise. This is an orphan. It's an animal, might have come from Florida, might have come from Alabama, but it can't be returned to where it originally came from because no one knows where it came from. So we've used these waif tortoises to try to help establish an adult population of tortoises here as one part of the project that we're all working on together, with our goal of getting about 250 adults out here for a minimum viable population.
Hi, I'm Lisa Lord with the Longleaf Alliance, and the Longleaf Alliance has been providing technical assistance and financial assistance to landowners and private land managers across the South since 1995, and we're excited now to be partnering with all of these folks to restore the gopher tortoise.
Hi, I'm Jason Ayers, coordinator for the South Carolina Coastal Programs of the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service. Currently, the gopher tortoise is a candidate species, could someday be a threatened or endangered species, but we hope through efforts like we talked about today and through some other efforts with the Longleaf Alliance that will not be needed, because we will have recovered the population such an extent that, hey, it's recovered, no longer needed to be listed as threatened or endangered. We have funded several DNR projects, and most recently we funded the Longleaf Alliance through some state and private lands work as well.
And my name is Scott Paugh from Riverbanks Zoo. Riverbanks' role in this project has been twofold. We provide funding for wildlife biologists, state regulatory agencies, and we also will keep baby tortoises for a year or so to head start them before they're big enough to put radio transmitters on and to release back into the wild.
And we are really excited about this partnership and moving forward and having new partners coming to the table to help increase the capacity to provide head started tortoises out here and help establish tortoises at this site.
This is a partnership where sometimes it's not enough to just protect the number of populations that we have left on threatened species. This is an opportunity to build a new population and actually be proactive in our conservation efforts.